Now to South Africa, where this is a national day of prayer and reflection to remember the former president, Nelson Mandela. It's the start of a series of events that will lead up to a massive funeral in 1 week. And ABC's Byron Pitts is in South Africa. Byron.
Good morning, Dan. The wave of humanity continues here. Despite the threat of rain in this, the rainy season in South Africa, people continue to show up here by the hundreds. Each day we see the rainbow that is the new South Africa. People of all religions, all colors, all united in their affection for this one man, Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela was not a particularly religious man, but today in churches and houses of worship across South Africa, prayers and songs for the man who had an abiding faith in the human spirit and in his nation to move beyond apartheid.
To keep his legacy going, we need to keep living what he's set out for us.
He was a hero. He fought for us and he suffered for the whole world.
The mood here remains more celebratory than somber. Overnight, Mandela's family spokesman speaking to the media for the first time, with Mandela's grandson close by.
In our hearts and souls, he will always be with us.
Today's National Day of Prayer kicks off a week-long celebration. Next up, a memorial service on Tuesday, taking place at the FNB Stadium in Johannesburg, where Mandela made his last public appearance at the 2010 World Cup. It's confirmed President Obama and the First Lady will be there, along with former President George W. Bush and Mrs. Bush, former President Jimmy Carter, former President Bill Clinton and Mrs. Clinton are expected at the funeral next Sunday. Wednesday through Friday, Mandela will lie in state in the nation's legislative capital, Pretoria. And finally, next Sunday, the state funeral in Mandela's hometown of Kounou on the Eastern Cape. His longtime friend and lawyer, George Bizos.
He will go down in history, I think, as the revolutionary who didn't believe in violence.
Earlier today, we had our first public sighting of Winnie Mandela, Nelson Mandela's former wife and partner in the dark days of apartheid. Tomorrow will be relatively quiet in South Africa, but then on Tuesday, a gathering like the world has never seen before, as dignitaries from around the globe gather in Johannesburg to bid farewell to Nelson Mandela. Beata?
Week of mourning and reflection and celebration. Our thanks to you. And Nelson Mandela has a very large and complicated family tree with over a dozen grandchildren. Some of them opened up to ABC's Rena Ninen in a rare interview during a recent visit to South Africa, and she's here to tell us about it. Good morning, Rena.
Good morning to you, Bianca. That's right, 17 grandkids and three wives, everyone vying for his time and affection. And there was one thing that he did from his prison cell that still brings his family comfort.
Set free after 27 years in prison.
His first steps into a new South Africa.
But some of Mandela's grandchildren found themselves longing for his prison days.
Those are the days that I cherish because it was just the two of you, nobody else. Because when he came out, we did not have him because he had bigger issues to tackle.
Armando!
His grandson, Kwaku, remembers visiting him when he was four.
He asked the wardens if they could put cartoons on the TV so that me and my other cousins could come and sit down and watch them. And then he offered us hot chocolate and, you know, he made it himself.
His granddaughter says while he couldn't physically touch them, his words always did.
At the end of the visit, he had bought me a box of black magic chocolates with the message saying that your visit will always be a bittersweet memory for me.
Words in the form of letters written to the family from jail. This one describing the moment he was told his son, Indeleka's father, was killed in a car accident.
It describes that his heart seems to stop and it was like the blood in his veins were frozen like ice.
And while their moments together were limited, this grandfather's wisdom was not, imparting lessons even from his prison cell.
Life is about cycles. His perseverance throughout his spell in prison and how he didn't let that break him, how he kept going ultimately.
His grandson also said Mandela told his family, you have to believe in something more than just yourself. Mandela also told him that he will always know, that he always knew he would defeat apartheid, and that's really what kept him going when he was in jail. Dan and Bianna.
And it worked. Rena, thank you. Let's bring in now ABC's George Stephanopoulos, who will be talking about Mandela and his legacy later this morning right here on ABC on This Week.
Good morning,
George,
guys.
Good morning. You're going to be talking about the impact on American politics.
Yeah, you know, we're just talking about that anti-apartheid movement. So many American politicians and American activists cut their teeth in the movement to fight apartheid in South Africa, including President Obama. One of the things we're going to take a look at today is his Mandela's relationship with American presidents, both starting with that anti-apartheid movement, also once he became a president, his work with Bill Clinton, his work with George W. Bush. You know, he would tangle with presidents. He was very fierce critic of President Bush on the issue of the Iraq War, but also worked closely with him on the issue of AIDS, and he was also a great consoler of President Clinton during his toughest times of the impeachment trial as well. And so we're going to look at all that today. Also, look at the really talk to some people who knew him very, very well. The human rights lawyer who helped draft the Constitution of South Africa with Nelson Mandela, his pollster in the presidential election. So we're trying to look at Nelson Mandela, the politician, and his impact on American politics.
And not to take away from his amazing accomplishments as president of South Africa, the country is still plagued by problems, both economic and racial.
Even though they're coming together and all coming together for Nelson Mandela, you've got economic inequality right now, you've got social inequality right now, a 40% unemployment rate among young blacks. So yes, they know that this time, this moment with Mandela passing is also a time for reflection on what more they need to do.
Maybe it's a time for them to all unite around the one man that really had a vision to change that country. Mm-hmm. All right, George, thanks.
Thanks, George.
And George, we'll have much more on all of this later this morning on ABC's This Week.